Hello, I am Nural Yılmaz from Marmara University. I'll be presenting our work on neural network-based inverse dynamics identification and external force estimation on the Da Vinci Research Kit. Although laparoscopic surgery has a lot of advantages like small incisions, less blood loss, it has also some significant drawbacks. For example, wrist-bending motions are lost, motion needs to be mirrored by the surgeon, operating positions are uncomfortable, and also hand-eye coordination is poor. Then it is possible to solve all of these problems with robotic-assisted minimal invasive surgery. However, current minimal invasive surgical robot systems do not provide force feedback. As a result of this, surgeons cannot feel the reaction forces inside the body and lose their sense of touch. Force feedback is important in the surgery because it provides safe control actions to surgeons during operations, and also it improves the quality and safety of the surgery. There are several research studies aiming to achieve force feedback in surgical operations. For example, some researchers have focused on developing miniaturized sensors. Some have developed force estimation algorithms. In addition to them, development of models for parameter identification is common as well. The other well-known approach is learning-based methods. The method which we propose is a kind of learning-based approach. When we look at it, it's mostly different from other learning-based approaches because we are not using any additional force sensor for training. On the contrary, external forces are estimated from joint torque and joint state measurements, which are position and velocity in our case. Inverse dynamics identification is realized by black box models in the form of neural networks, and then we don't need to know exact model parameters. The purpose of this procedure is that inverse dynamic forces are filtered from torque measurements, then we can obtain the external force estimates. Also in this method, the operator controls the slave in the workspace of the robot, as dynamic identification is performed without an automated excitation trajectory. In this way, this helps reduce the discrepancy between the surgical workspace and the automatically generated trajectory. The backbone of our method is the dynamic identification based on neural network. If there is no external force acting on the robot, the dynamic model can be described for any robot in joint space using this equation. And this equation includes any forces affecting the dynamic behavior of the robot except external forces like inertial forces, Coriolis and centrifugal force torques, gravitational forces, friction force torques, and internal force torques. Here, internal force torques can be any forces which are uncertain on the mechanism. As you know, DVRK utilizes tandem driving mechanisms for both motion and force transmission. Then, identifying the dynamic model accurately becomes difficult due to the uncertain system parameters, friction, elongation, and elasticity. As a result, the dynamic terms in the equation are not exactly known. However, we can define the summation as a lump model. Here, we want our neural network to learn the robot dynamics depending on the position and velocity signals. As you see in the figures, for more accurate results, each joint owns its neural network. Therefore, we don't need to normalize the data. As I already said in the previous slide, a separate neural network is utilized for each joint, and in total, we make use of 6 neural networks for the Da Vinci Research Kit. If we look at the network structure, each model has one input layer with 12 input neurons, which are position and velocity measurement vectors. There is one hidden layer with 100 neurons. Also, we have one output layer with one neuron representing the individual predicted actuator torque. In the other part of the method, we are taking external forces into account, and the dynamic equation becomes this, in the joint space, of course. If we subtract dynamic force estimates from joint torque measurements, we can obtain purely external joint forces. And finally, if we multiply them by the inverse transpose of the robot Jacobian, we can obtain external forces in Cartesian space. Let's see the experiment section. We implemented and tested our method on the Da Vinci PSM. In all experiments, DVRK PSM was unilaterally operated by a human operator with an MTM. Also, we performed the estimation results offline with post-processing operation. In training operation, the PSM was moved by providing different poses and velocities via the MTM, and this operation was realized by unilateral teleoperation. You can see this training motion in the video, by the way. In order to train a network, we recorded position and velocity signals for input neurons, torque signals for output neurons. Approximately, we gathered 415,000 samples for this procedure. Here, you can see the relation between joint states and actuator force torque during training operation. The x and y axis show the joint position and velocity, respectively, whereas the color scale represents the force torque measurements. In order to validate dynamic identification, we collected the test data by moving the robot to different positions with different orientation and velocities. As understood from the experiment video, this part is similar to the previous part, which is training operation. In this experiment, our network models tried to predict joint force torques depending on the given position and velocity responses. Here you can see the joint torque identification results. In the graph, the blue line shows the actual force torque, that is measured force torque, whereas the red line represents the estimated force torque. And the dashed black line shows the error values. Actually, the difference between actual force torques and estimated force torques must give us the external forces. I mean the errors must be equal to zero because the robot is moving in free space. Then, when we compare our estimation results with joint force torque measurements, we can see that they are almost equal to each other with very small error values. To evaluate the performance of our method, we used two different error calculation formulas given on the right. Additionally, we were able to compare our results with some other methods utilized in the literature by using the given error formulas. And it can be said that our method is better than or comparable to others, as can be seen from the table. Here, another important point is that using separate neural networks for each joint provides an improvement over the single neural network. For validation of external force estimation in Cartesian X, Y, and Z axis, we placed a force sensor to a platform and we mounted a 3D printed apparatus with square holes to the top of the sensor, because we wanted to touch in each axis separately. In these plots, the blue line shows the sensor output, whereas the red line represents the estimation results. When there is contact with the sensor, it can be observed that estimation results of each axis are in agreement with the sensor output, and estimation error is less than 10% in each axis. As can be seen from the table, our results are comparable with the results in the literature. For more accurate results, the experiment setup could be improved and the direct contact with the sensor may be provided. This is our last experiment, which is stiffness identification. In this experiment, we performed a palpation case study. Here, our purpose to demonstrate the feasibility of the method for clinical purposes by differentiating the relative stiffness values of three different phantom objects. Third object has the highest stiffness, whereas the first object has the lowest stiffness. We tried to obtain this relationship as a result of this experiment using our method. During this experiment, the robot touched seven random points on each phantom and for some position data were recorded. Then we estimated external forces using our method and we plotted them with respect to changes in tool position as shown in this figure. Stiffness can be determined from the slope of this plot. Since the exact stiffness values of the phantoms were not available, we performed the same calculation with force sensor placed under the phantoms. This table shows that average stiffness values obtained by the proposed method and the sensor are close to each other. Also, the given bar graph shows that we found correct relation when we compare the estimated stiffness values. So, our method can be useful in surgical operations like tissue differentiation. Let me conclude my presentation here. First, our experiments show that the measured force torque and estimated force torque by the neural network are very close to each other. It is clear that dynamic identification is realized accurately on each joint. In the case of contact with the sensor, in the other words, if there is external force acting on the robot, estimation results in each axis are in agreement with the sensor outputs. The other important point is that our method can be used in surgical operations requiring tissue differentiation. We believe that it could be practical for surgeons. Also, actually, this method can be considered as the first step of deep learning, and it can be used to generate deep neural networks that can be trained with data from different operations, instruments, or maybe surgeons. And I would like to thank you for attending our presentation. I will be happy to answer any questions you may have.